What's up, investors? It's your boy, Mr. Rushu, aka the Cash Flow Investor. Welcome back to the channel. And if it's your first time, make sure you hit that sub button so you don't miss any of the new content. As y'all can tell, this video is about creating a cash flow dividend portfolio. And my dream has always been to be able to use my capital to buy cash flowing assets that I can eventually use to live off of. You know, I can use them for emergencies, I can use them for extra spending. And it's funny because if into the YouTube financial space, you notice that most people think dividends are a losing battle. I beg to differ, because when you need that cash in desperate times, dividends can be there to save you. So let's get right into it. The examples that I'll be giving here are not recommendations. They're just the way that I'm structuring my portfolio to optimize dividend growth, yield, and capital appreciation. So in order for you to really understand what I'm trying to accomplish, I got to explain what my goals and my mind frame are. To start, I'm a long-term investor, and so having 30 plus years in my timeline, I have plenty of time to weather drawbacks and other financial situations. Keeping this in mind, my dividend stock selections must have two very important things. They gotta have dividend growth and capital appreciation. With that being said, I'm looking to have supplemental income within the next 5 years. And so I'll be looking for choices to boost up my current dividend yield, providing cash flow right now. So first up, one of the first things that I'm looking at, of course, is SPY, or ticker symbol IVV. And this is gonna be one of the cornerstones of my portfolio, and 15% of my invested cash will be going towards this asset. You might be thinking, why the S&P 500? And honestly, it's because it's able to average about 10% growth yearly over the next 30 years. This will also provide increasing cash flow, as the dividend growth rate is roughly about 11% year over year. Now, a lot of people don't realize that the S&P 500 is one of the best ways to achieve dividend growth, even though the yield is low. The actual payout increases almost every year. And so this is one of the things that I really want in my dividend portfolio. The next key in my portfolio will be ticker symbol SCHD. And if you have been watching YouTube, everybody loves this ticker. I've been investing in it since 2016. And this is one of the biggest things in my portfolio right now, where I invest about 30% of my cash. The symbol grows dividends at about 11% a year and currently has above a 3% dividend yield. It's a cash flow machine. Like, literally every quarter you can expect your dividend is going to be increased. Now, the next part of my cash flow portfolio is JEPQ. I love tech, and this option selling ETF is a huge win in my book. Now, over the last year, it's grown about 8.48%, which honestly is underperforming the S&P 500. But what you have to look at is that they pay an 11% dividend yield. And this yield, it kind of depends on how much premium they're able to sell with their options. So this is why you can't really rely on this ETF to pay out a consistent dividend. We know that it's going to come every month. We just don't know what the amount will be. Sometimes it'll be higher, sometimes it'll be lower. It really just depends on the state of the market. However, I can tell you that if we were to experience a significant drawback in the technology space, we would come out winning big with JEPQ, as the premiums that are being sold on JEPQ will be a lot higher, and so that payout will be much higher. So this is fine with me, because in situations like that where the market does go down, I know that I'm going to be getting returned more cash, so I can deploy that or use that as needed. And finally, you guys know I love growth, but we are here for the cash flow. My final allocation is 10% into XLK. This is a pure technology fund that grows capital at about 15% year over year and grows its dividend as well by about 12 to 13%. Right now, I think we've brought our total up to 75% of our cash allocated. I keep about 25% in cash, not necessarily all at the same time, but my weekly deposit, I keep about 25% to just keep for just bargains that I might find on the stock market, or just other stocks that I may want to invest in at my discretion. So these can either be dividend stocks that I've had my eye on, or they can be some stocks that are growth stocks that are trading at a discounted price from their highs. And so I'll use that cash to deploy in and buy shares like that. Then one of the best ways I think to capture upside and receive cash is by selling covered calls. So in some of these other positions, once I get my position up to about 100 shares, then now I'm able to generate even more cash by selling options. So between SCHD, XLK, and IVV, I've got plenty of growth and dividend growth that will ensure that my yearly payouts are constantly growing. And then I got that dividend booster that's coming from JEPQ that's ensuring that, hey, I'm getting this high yield dividend payment and that capital is still continuing to grow. So for me, this is pretty big. This is how I balance my portfolio between my big four, which is SCHD, XLK, IVV, and JEPQ. And then after that, I sprinkle in some other companies. These could be companies like Starbucks, Vici, things like that. And we can go into some other, and maybe in the future, in some other videos, I can explain to you guys exactly what are some of my other dividend stocks that necessarily aren't ETFs. But like I said, this is the actual way of how I'm building my dividend portfolio. So like I said, none of the information in this video is a recommendation. This is just how I'm structuring my portfolio for cash flow. And, you know, we'll see. In the next video, I'll show you guys what I project this account to produce over the coming years. We can hop into the dividend calculator and kind of show you what the averages for all of these stocks would end up coming to. So hopefully I got some value from this video. And if you did, hit that subscribe button, drop a like. Let me know your thoughts in the comments. As always, it's your boy, Mr. Roshu, a.k.a. The Cashflow Investor. And I'll catch you on the next one. Peace.